join me in our opening prayer? Holy One, we come before you in awe, for you have promised never to leave us, ever. It is an awesome thing. Even when we feel most lost and alone, still you are with us. Your Spirit is there as comforter, advocate, and friend. Help us to know and celebrate your presence with us always. Amen.
In this place, on our journey to be faithful people, we gather this day in love. Let us pray. Forgiving One, unseen yet known, we hear the world speak in power and in greed, and we hear you speak in love and grace. May our lives be lived in the echo of your voice. When we are persuaded by the want that leads to hurt, the hankering that leads to greed, the yearning that leads to selfishness.
Thank you.
Facebook page this week, you might have noticed in the detail of the invitation to church this morning that I referenced Christopher Robin. Did you see that? So, as I was reading the text for today, I was reminded of how Christopher Robin, who was Winnie the Pooh's good friend, and when it was time for Christopher to begin going to school, Winnie was really concerned because they wouldn't be hanging out all day long with each other in the 100-acre wood anymore. And so they spent their last day before school began, and Christopher kept wanting to tell Winnie, but just never got around to it. Something always interrupted. And finally, as Winnie is falling asleep in the tree, and Christopher is realizing it's about time for him to head home for dinner, he whispers to Winnie. Do you remember what he whispered? There's three parts to it, and so I always have to write it down because I get it wrong. This is what he whispered to Winnie as Winnie was falling asleep. You're braver than you believe. You're stronger than you seem. And you're smarter than you think. Christopher Robin was preparing Winnie the Pooh to be able to get through the days ahead when he'd be at school by really digging deep into his own reserves. I'm guessing that there is someone in your life, even if you're a 2-year-old, who has given you some good advice, and it could be as simple as, put your jacket on before you go out, or don't forget to wear your helmet before you get on your bike. Or it might be something like, you could do that. I invite you, for just a minute, to think about someone in your life who has said something to you that you draw upon when things get tough. I'm going to be quiet so you can think about that for a minute. What I'd like you to do now, and I know this is going to be challenging for some folks who prefer to come to church and sit by themselves all the time, because you need that space. I'm going to invite you to either turn towards someone near you, if there's someone near you, or move closer to someone. And I would invite you to share with them what you thought of. And it might be, you know, I couldn't think of anyone in particular. Or I've got this whole long list. Or it might be something completely different. But let's just take a couple minutes now and share with the person sitting close to you, or close to you. And if you need to turn around over the pew, please feel free to do that. So some of you may have discovered the things that surprised you, maybe in hearing the other person, it reminded you of something else, or you may have just been surprised about what came up or didn't come up. But this is a conversation for you to continue. There is so much wisdom in our family, in our friends, in strangers, right? And it's in the right moment, it's a gift. Our text today comes from what's referred to as the farewell discourse in the Gospel of John. It's like four chapters long. And the text actually began as one of the readings last week. And it begins with, Jesus is trying to comfort the disciples and let them know that they're not going to be on their own. And in last week's text, the first part of chapter 14, Jesus promises an abiding place with God. He promises a sure and clear way to God. He promises to sustain the believing community. Well, look, we're still here. And he also promises that those who love Jesus will be empowered to do things even greater than what he, Jesus, did. Jesus says this in the Gospel of John. And today, it's really a summary of his ministry. It is about love. It is that God is love, and that Jesus and the paraclete will be with you. Love one another. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And what is the commandment? To love one another. It's almost as if it's circular, right? But it makes when you love, it's just the remembering, the words of wisdom from a parent, or the words of wisdom from a child, or the words of wisdom from someone else that push you into the realization, all right, I am not alone. What I am doing, I am not alone. And I gotta tell you, we're gonna need that sense. We're gonna need to have that faith in love and the ability to love. Because, you know, I've got this, the current construction calendar. This is what it looks like. And I understand that it's already changed. But things are gonna be different around here for a while as we do what we're committed to do, which is to make more ADA compliant bathrooms, which shifts the whole space over in the parlor area. You know how after worship we go to the parlor? We go to the parlor for fellowship, we go to the parlor for conversation. We won't be doing that for the next few months because we will do it. It doesn't start yet. As I said, it's a moving target. Lee walked into my office this morning, or actually he was standing outside my office, and says, whoa, you're cleaning house here? And I said, everything's got to come out because of the construction. Even though we're not redoing those parts of the offices, the stuff is going to be awful in there. So things are going to be different. And so the extent to which we can all feel like we are part of the beloved community and lift up the incredible work that Delina Wilkerson and Debbie Kent are doing to keep us on the straight and narrow through this so that it's done. By the time we get back to the regular programming in September, it will be done. We still get to worship every Sunday here in the sanctuary. We don't get moved. A couple years ago, we got moved. We got moved into the chapel. We get to stay right here. We'll be using the chapel for more things than we have been. But that's what we need to do, right? Because it can be upsetting. Right? But we can do this. I know we can do this. So here Jesus is sitting at the table with the disciples. And they're going, oh no, it's about over. We're not going to have you here to show us the way anymore. And Jesus says, you know the way. And God will send another advocate, and I will be with you. Yeah. I am reminded again of the memorial services that we've had here at Pilgrim in the past month and a half, and how the women whose lives we celebrated made it clear to their children and their family what was most important: caring for each other, being of service, making a positive impact on the world. It was clear as day. It's simple and so hard when we're feeling caught up in the events of the day that just rage around us, when we're caught up in the detail of what's going to happen at Pilgrim for the next few months as we make these important improvements. As we look at what we're going to be as faith community together and how we walk together, being open to each other, being open to the needs and wants of each other, being present for each other. This story about love today is not about my boyfriend, Jim. This story about love, although I do believe that he and I do have a commitment that's more than what I was just implying. It is the ability to be there for someone else, the ability to act based on what is good for someone else, the ability to be present, and not just thinking about what I need in this moment. Our culture is so caught up in what do I need to do? Well, you know, what do I need today? And I think in this faith community, we are able to set that aside and to explore what do we as a faith community need? What does the world need from us as a faith community? Jesus promises to always be with us. Only are you going to be okay. You're going to do amazing things, even better than what I've been able to accomplish. It's as simple as love. It's as hard as love. But we can do it.